Hello and welcome to this video tutorial. My name is Sven Goldstein and I'm product manager for our TwinCAT automation software, especially for the area of connectivity. In this video tutorial, I would like to give you a getting started introduction into our product TF6100 OPC UA Server. For this video tutorial, I've prepared a virtual machine on which I have already installed either the 4D24 setup or the 4D26 workload. The first thing that you want to do when you want to get started with our TwinCAT OPC UA server is that you need to initialize our OPC UA server. During this initialization, the server is configured with a user account that OPC UA clients then have to use in order to connect to the OPC UA server. The initialization is easily being done with via one of our configurator tools. So for this, I have installed our standalone configurator, and you can find this configurator tool on the Windows Start menu in the folder Beckhoff. And the TF6100 OPC UA configurator is then an entry in that folder. So we start this configurator, and once we have started it, we need to set up a server connection, which means the configurator uses an OPC UA connection to connect to the server and then configure the server. For this, we need to click on the Edit button in the toolbar. Then we would like to connect to our locally running OPC UA server. So we enter the server URL for a localhost connection. We retrieve the endpoints from the server, and then we simply connect to the first endpoint that is shown here in this drop-down menu. So we add this connection to our server list, and then we can close this window and connect to the server. The first thing that the configurator shows the user is a message that tells the user that this server has not been initialized yet. So it is in factory default mode. No user account has been configured for this server yet. So what we want to do now here is we enter a username password combination, and then this username is actually compared to the user database from the operating system. And if that user account does not exist yet on the operating system, it is being configured there automatically. So as a username, we would like to use, for example, the username admin, and we set up a secure password that meets the complexity requirements of the operating system. We click on OK. Then in the background, the server is configured and is initialized with this user account and is restarted automatically. And by clicking on the connect button once more, we can now connect to the server using this username password combination. So the username is automatically entered by the configurator tool. We just need to enter the password here. We click on OK, and then a connection to the OPC UA server is established. So we see the connection state is connected. We can switch, for example, to the online panel. We can see some status information of the server. We can see the current server time. We can see the software version. We can see what kind of license is running on the server, whether it is a 7-day trial license or maybe a full license. And we can also see some session-related information, see how many clients are currently connected to the server, how many nodes have been imported by the server into its address space. All this kind of meta information is visible there. So what we want to do now is we want to connect a regular OPC UA client to the server in order to browse through its namespace. And for that, we want to use our TwinCAT OPC UA sample client that is automatically installed together with the server setup. And this application can also be found on the Windows Start menu. Again, the same folder, the Beckhoff folder on the Start menu. And here you will find the sample client. So we start the sample client. And the procedure is the same as in the configurator. So we connect to our locally running OPC UA server using the localhost URL. We retrieve the endpoints. We connect to the first endpoint that is retrieved and shown here on this drop-down list. And then we enter our username password combination that we have used to initialize the server. So now we are connected to the server and we can navigate through the server namespace. So we can expand the objects folder and we will find the PLC1 object here. And this is the same object that is where the PLC variables from the first PLC runtime are being displayed. So right now we only see some meta information here, some meta variables, but we don't see any PLC variables yet because simply we don't have any PLC variables configured yet to be exposed via OPC UA. But that's what we want to do now. So for that, I have a TwinCAT XIE running here in the background, and I have already added a PLC project with a very simple variable, very simple PLC program. And it just contains a counter variable, right? So I have a counter variable here defined in my declaration area, and this variable is being incremented every PLC cycle. So in order to expose this variable via OPC UA now, all I need to do is I need to place this attribute here in front of the variable. It's also sometimes called a PLC pragma. So, and by placing this variable here, the OPC UA server knows that this variable has to be shown on its address space. Before we activate this project now, we make sure that two things are in place. So the first is a TF6100 license. So we switch to the TwinCAT license manager and we make sure that a TF6100 license is activated here. We have already seen that in the configurator that there is a 7-day trial license running here on our system. And I just want to confirm that. And yes, the license is 7-day trial license is still valid for 7 days. So that's fine. And the second thing that we want to make sure is that in the PLC project settings that we have activated the checkbox at the TMC target file. What happens in that case is that the TMC file, meaning the symbol file for this PLC project, is automatically being downloaded to the target. In our case, it's running on the same system, but it's being downloaded into the runtime. And from there, the TwinCAT OPC UA server will pick up the TMC file in order to browse through its content to see, okay, on which PLC variables has the PLC attribute been configured so that I need to display this variable in my address space. Okay, but this checkbox here is set, so we're all fine. And now we want to activate the TwinCAT project. We make sure that the PLC project is automatically started, and we click on OK. And if this dialog box here asks me to if we want to switch TwinCAT into run mode, we just confirm that so that we have a running TwinCAT program in the background. Okay, now I can switch back to my main program. I log into the PLC just to confirm that everything is running to our satisfaction. Yes, we have a counter variable, and this counter variable is being incremented every PLC cycle. So that's great. Now I want to switch back to my OPC UA client. So I minimize the XIE environment. I have my sample client running here. I just want to reconnect here so that my browser window is automatically refreshed. I log into the server again. And then I can browse to my PLC one node. And below the PLC one node, I now find my main program with the counter variables. And by double clicking this variable here, I will add a so-called subscription to the variable, and the variable values are being displayed here in the watch list. So that was it. That was our getting started video tutorial. So in this video tutorial, I've shown you how to initialize the OPC UA server, to configure it with a user account that OPC UA clients have to use in order to connect to the server. And we have also seen how to share a PLC variable on the OPC UA server address space by using the PLC attribute that we have seen earlier. So thank you very much for listening. Thank you very much for watching this video tutorial, and hopefully see you around and talk to you later. Thank you. Bye-bye.